नमस्कार। आज आप सभी को रामनवमी की हार्दिक शुभकामनाएं और मैं आशा करता हूं कि आप सभी लोग अपने घर में सपरिवार सुखद रूप से होंगे, सानंद होंगे और सभी लोग घर के अंदर रहकर ही मोदी जी को सपोर्ट कर रहे होंगे। चलिए अब अपनी बात करते हैं। सो टुडेज टॉपिक इज हार्मोन्स, मीन्स हार्मोन्स। द टर्म हार्मोन इज introduced by William M. Bialysis and Ernest Sterling. These are scientists who just give this term, and there's a question is what is hormones. Generally we can always say hormones are the different chemicals which are secreted in our body, but still we can say hormones are the chemical messengers that regulate the biological process in the living organisms. Means these are the chemical substances which can always help for the managing all kinds of the biological process in our body. Then there is a question that how the hormones can be transported in our body. Means how these hormones can always transfer from one place to another place. Means generally these chemicals can always, with the help of our body, and they can be transported to a specific organs. Those organs are called the target organs. Means when the blood can be get these hormones from the different glands directly in them, they can be transported specific organs, that is called the target organs. And these all target organs have and specific things, specific substances on their surfaces. Means these cells can have specific surfaces in which the cytoplasm and the specific protein and molecules which are known as the receptors. Means the different target organ can have also specific receptors through which they can be get these chemical substance, and they will get the message, and through that message they can perform the different kinds of activities in the body. So there are different characteristics of the hormones. The first, that hormones are secreted by living cells to act and chemical messengers, and they are organic compounds to be diverse nature. They can secrete in small amount by the cell of endocrine glands, mean different glands which can secrete hormones. They are known as endocrine glands, and they are poured indirectly into the blood and carried by the different parts of the body, as well as they can act away from site of their production. Means hormones can always show their actions from their production places, from their site of actions, right? As well as the hormones are generally slow in action. Means hormone cannot show the immediately actions. They can show their actions slowly and slowly. These hormones can always secreted by the different kinds of glands, basically endocrine glands. And means what is gland? The gland is a cell or a tissue or an organ which secrete certain useful chemical compounds required for the particular function in our body is called the gland. On the basis of these glands, they can be classified in different categories. Number one is exocrine glands, number two endocrine glands, and third one is the heterocrine glands. Exocrine glands are those glands which can have the ducts, means they can always secrete their substances, secreted substances directly with the help of those ducts and on the body surfaces, means or into the cavity of our body. For example, the sweat gland, sebaceous glands in skin, salivary gland around the buccal cavity, gastric glands in the stomach wall, and liver are, these are the different examples of the exocrine glands. Second, that is called known as endocrine gland. These endocrine glands are known as also ductless glands because they do not have any duct to pass their secretory substances, means they can be always discharged direct into the bloodstream, and through the blood they can be transported to their receptor or to their target organs. So maximum number of glands in our body, they are endocrine.